Hello friends, in this video we come to know about shortest path and its algorithm. So path, we know what is path. Path is the combination of vertices and edges more, where no vertex repeated more than once. Now shortest path means what? So shortest path means if G is a graph and U and V be the two vertices in it, then there may exist several paths connecting U and V. Among those, the path containing minimum number of edges is called the shortest path between U and V. So for example, let this one is the graph and we want to move from the vertex A to the vertex D. Now if you want to move from A to D, then look, there are so many paths are available. So for example, A to I, I to H, H to F, F to E, E to D, that is one of the path. Again A to H, H to F, F to E, E to D, that is one more path. Again A to H, H to F, F to G, G to D, this is another one. And again this way we can move, this is one more path. A to B, B to D, this is one more. So look, there are so many paths in between A to D. Among all these paths, which one is the shortest, that is our concern. So how to find out the shortest? At first we count the number of edges involving on those paths. Among all those paths, which path contain the minimum number of edges, that one is called the shortest path. So here these are all possible paths from A to D. First path contains 1, 2, 3 and 4, so 4 number of edges, so its length is 4. Second path, its length is again 4. Third path, its length is 5. Its length is 5 and its length is 2. So we can say A to D, if you want to reach, then the shortest path is A to B, B to D. So this is the shortest path when the graph is a unweighted graph. Unweighted means no edges have a specific weight provided. No weights are provided means each edge having the value 1 as its weight. Now weighted graph is what? That already we know. Weighted graph means if a graph have specified some specific weights. For example, suppose this graph is given. Here the weights are given as 1, 2, 3. This is also 3, 2, 2, 3. It is 5, it is 8, then it is 2 and it is 2. So these are the weights provided to the graph. So now it becomes the weighted graph. So if for this graph we want to find out the weight, we want to find out the shortest path in between A to D, then we should find out what should be the shortest path. So here definitely A to B, B to D may not be the shortest path, because if your graph is the weighted graph, that time for all the selected paths, we should add the corresponding weights of these edges. After adding all those weights, we will find out a specific total weight of the entire path. Among all the possible paths, which path have the minimum weight, that is the shortest path. So if we do so, then for here, if we consider the first path, then A to H is its weight is 1, then H to F its weight is 2, F to E its weight is 3, E to D then its weight is again 3. So that its total weight is 3, 3, 6, then 3, 9. So its total weight is 9. Similarly for the second one, its weight is 1, 3, 5 and 2, that is 7. Its weight is 2, 2, 4, 6, 9, then 12. Then its weight is 2, 2, 4, 2, 6, 2, 8, 2, 10. And its weight is 8 and 5, it is 13. So after calculation of all these weights, we find out that this is the minimum weight. Hence, the path, this one, then this one, and this one. This is the shortest path. So, according to the situation, the shortest path will change. So, shortest path for the weighted graph, for the definition we can say, Let G be a weighted graph, U and P be two vertices in G. The sum of the weights of all the edges in a path is called weight of the path. Among all the paths connecting U and V, the path having the minimum weight is called shortest path between U and V in the graph. So, here we will find out that in between two vertices, there may be more than one path. So, if there are so many paths, so among all those paths, which one is the shortest? That searching is very much tedious if there are suppose so many paths. So, for that, we have an algorithm by which directly we can find out exactly the shortest path only. So, this algorithm is named as the Dijkstra's algorithm. So, Dijkstra's algorithm to find out the shortest path. So, how to apply this algorithm? So, initially, this one is the graph given. In this graph, it is a weighted graph. And look, here the self loop, even the parallel edges are also given. For the path, no self loop, no parallel edges are required. That's why initially we simplify the given graph. How to simplify? We should remove the self loop first. Then we remove the parallel edges with the highest or the greater weights. So we just keep among all the parallel edges the edge which have the minimum weight. So if we reduce this one, so look here, these are the three parallel edges. Among these three, the edge, this one have the weight 8. So we should keep this edge and remove these two. Similarly, these two edges in between, 3 is the minimum weight. That's why we keep this one and remove this one. And we definitely remove this one, this parallel, this self loop. After all this removal, we will find out this is the simple graph, simple weighted graph. So now, here the question is, you should find out the shortest path between V3 to V6. Our target is to find out the shortest path between V3 to V6. So V3 is this vertex and V6 is this vertex. So now how to proceed? So we just create a table. So in this table, initially at the 0th label, what we will do, our starting point is what? That is V3. So we assign the value 0 to the V3, and that is set the starting label or the base label for the vertex V3. It is the starting point. Now the remaining all the vertices here in this table, we just write all these vertices first, and this is the remark column. So now V3 having assigned the labeling value 0, and remaining all the vertices we should assign the value infinity. And the remark column, we write V3 is the starting vertex. Now, in the next stage, what we will do, we should start our traversing from V3. So, V3 is connected with V2 and V4. If a vertex is connected with any other vertex, then accordingly we assign the label. And if two vertices are not at all connected, then we assign the label as infinity. So, V3 connected with V2. So, V3, its labeling value is 0. That is the permanent label. That is fixed. Now, from V3 to V2, there is a connectivity and its weight is 7. So, what happens? The previous weight of the previous labeling value for the vertex V2 is infinity. Now, as it is connected with V3 and V2 are connected. That's why. Now, its value, we should say 0 is the base value. So, 0 plus 7, that is total 7. So, among these two, previously it is infinity, now it is 0 plus 7. So, among these two, which one is the minimum value? The value is 7. That's why we assign the value 7 to the vertex V2. Again, V3 is connected with V4. So, come to the V4. Here, previous value is infinity, now it is 0 plus 1. So that its value is 1. So among these two, the minimum value is 1. Hence, we assign it as the 1 value. With the vertex V3, no other vertices are directly connected. That's why their labeling value is still infinity. Hence, previously it is infinity, still it is infinity, so it is infinity. Accordingly, all the remaining are infinity. After assigning the new labeling values, we search that which value is the minimum among all those vertices. So we will find out this is the minimum value. That is already done. So this is the minimum value. So this is corresponding to the vertex V4. So in the remarks column, we should write V4 gets its permanent label. After getting this one, we should move to the vertex V4. So this is our next point. After moving to the V4, we find out V4 connected with the vertex V2, V7 and V5. Here one thing you should remember, which vertex gets its permanent label, we should not do anything with those vertex again. Which vertex are not yet get the permanent label, for them only we change according to the connectivity. So now V4 connected to V2. So come to here. So V4 have the labeling value 1. Previous value for the label of V2 is 7. Now it is 1 plus V4 to V2, it is 3. So previous its valuation is 1 and it is 3. So 1 plus 3 means 4. So 7 is the previous, new is the 4. Among these two, the minimum value is the 4. So that the minimum labeling value for V2 is 4. Again, V4 is connected with V5. So here, V4 is connected with V5 means previous value is infinity. Now it is 1 plus 3. So it is 4. So minimum of these two is definitely 4. Similarly, V4 is connected with V7 also. So it is previously 1. Now it is 4. So total 5. So V7, 4, we will find out previously it is infinity. Now it is 5. So minimum of these two is 5. So it is 5. So, and the remaining are the infinity because there are no direct connectivity with V4. After doing all these, we just again search that what is the minimum value in all these labeling values. This is already selected. This is already selected. So among them, 4 is the minimum value. But here 4 occurs at two places. If there is a tie, that means 4 occurs in more than one places, then we should choose any one of them. Remember, any one of them. So let us choose V5 as our permanent label here. And in the remark, we should write V5 gets the permanent label. So we move to the V5. Now again, similarly, we search V5 connecting with V6, V7 and V4. Or yes, it is also with V1. So V4, V5 is connected, but we will not get back here because V4 already gets its permanent label. So V5 connected with V1, V6 and V7. Accordingly, if we will change in the previous way, then we will find out that this one with here V1 is connected and previous level is infinity. Now it is 4 plus 10 means it is total 14. Now V2 is previously 4. Now no connectivity, that means it is infinity, that's why minimum is 4. Similarly here it is 5, previously already it is there, and it is 11. And among all these, the minimum value is 4, so that in this label V2 gets its permanent label. So that we should write in the remarks column that V2 gets the permanent label. So that we move to V2. So V2 is here. Its connectivity is with V1, V7. With V3, V4 also, but V3, V4 already gets its permanent level. That's why we concerned with V1 and V7 only. And accordingly, if we change the labeling values, so that we will find out all these labeling values. And here we will observe that the minimum labeling value is 5. Because these are selected, these are selected, these all are selected. So this is corresponding to the vertex V7. So we should write V7 gets its permanent label. Now come to the vertex V7. So from V7 now, if we choose, then we will find out V7 connected with V1, V5, V6, V5 already done. So V7 connected with V1 and V6. Accordingly, if we just change the labeling values, so we will find out here it is 8, this one is 7. And these all already get the permanent label. So this is the minimum. So we should write V6 gets the permanent label. Now our question is what? We should find out the shortest distance between V3 to V6. We have started from V3 and now look, we get V6 at it as its permanent level. That means we reach to the destination. Whenever your target point gets the permanent level, we should stop to do this table. So we should stop here. That means we already done our shortest path and its distance. So what is the shortest path and what is its length or what is the shortest distance? So shortest distance for we can say it has to be 7. Now how to find out the shortest path? So for that what we will do, this is the final destination. So we just observe these two leveling values, the two consecutive leveling values for this vertex. If these two leveling values are two different values, then we search that at the previous level, iteration, which vertex gets the permanent level. Here we will find out this vertex gets the permanent level, that is V7. So in the graph, we have V6 is the final destination and V7 gets its permanent level. So we just take this one. So V7 we will choose. From V7, now we again go to checking that these two are same or not. Yes, these are same. If it is same, then we go to the more upper value. So these two we should check. These two again same. So we should move more upward. So if we go here, then we just compare among these two. Yes, here these two are the two different values. Two different values means now at this level, which vertex gets permanent, that we should check. Here we will find out that V4 gets the permanent value. That means V7 to V4 we should traverse back. After V4, now your cursor should be come to the V4. And after V4, we just again go upward and we compare in between these two leveling values. If these two are different, we find out which vertex get the permanent level at this stage. Here it is V3. So from V4 to V3. So V3 is your starting point. Hence we will get the shortest path as V3 to V4, V4 to V7, V7 to V6, and its length is 1 plus 4 5 plus 2 it is 7. It is same as this length. So this is our shortest path algorithm by which we can find out the shortest path directly. Thank you for this lecture. Welcome.